Wouldn't it be nice to make a backup copy of your favorite Blu-ray or favorite 4K Blu-ray so the original doesn't get damaged? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do that, and we're going to check it out right after the jump. And I'm back. Okay, before we begin, first things first, of course, I want to give a big shout out and thank you to all my patrons on Patreon. You guys rock. I got a message from one of you guys. I think his name is Alan, and he is loving the demos. And he says the demos on my Patreon are much better than the ones he's found other places on the internet. So yeah, that's because they're from all of the actual demo discs. So if you guys want access to demo files on demo discs, definitely check out the link in my description. Become a patron at the $5 level today. Okay, so what is the point of making a backup of a disc? So I bought this DTS demo disc from 2017. I bought this on eBay. Now, since I only have one copy of this, I do not want to damage the disc. Right? I want to make a copy so that I can do whatever I want with the disc, and I can keep this in storage, you know, and I can, you know, play hell with the other one. I can use it as a coaster, you know, I can throw it around like a frisbee or whatever. So yeah, that's the main idea here, is to make a backup of a movie or whatever disc you've already purchased, and something that plays in your Blu-ray player so you can put the disc in storage somewhere or wherever you have it. I don't know, but just leave it in its case and pack it away somewhere so it doesn't get damaged. Now, you can do this with like your kid's favorite Blu-ray or 4K Blu-ray. The 4K Blu-rays, of course, if they're going to be large, like over 50 gigabytes per movie, that might be a little expensive, because the BDXL discs, we'll get into that in a minute, those are kind of expensive to get those blanks. But anyway, in my previous video, I showed you guys how to rip just the movie, either with M2TS or MKV. This is going to be a little bit different. This is going to take the entire disc and put it into one file, okay? This is called an image file, also known as an ISO. So we're going to take an image from the disc so that we will have everything. All the menus are going to be intact, all the languages, all the different audio tracks, all those things are going to be in there. Bonus features, if it has bonus features, that kind of thing. So everything is going to be there in the ISO file. All right, let's move on to the first thing, equipment. So I'm going to tell you what equipment I use and what software I use to make this all happen. There's a bunch of moving parts, so bear with me. First things first, if you're going to rip a 4K disc, you are definitely going to need a 4K friendly drive. Now, I got some from a guy named Alex. This is it right here. And yeah, you can find his information down in the description box. I'll put his email, and I'll put his email address up on screen here. Just shoot him an email saying you saw a video on YouTube from TechnoDad and you wanted to get a 4K friendly drive. So once you got that, that's one part, okay? Now, oddly enough, I burned the disc on a different drive, and it's an old drive I've had before. For some reason, this drive I got from Alex doesn't really like to work with my Mac when the burning process. So I don't know what that's about, but I got this little Pioneer drive here, and this thing is old. Like, I bought this thing in 2017, and I did find the newer model of it, and I'll link that, you know, from Amazon. That's going to be in the description down below as well. And it's actually been a trooper. It's, you know, burned all these things. So what's interesting about this older drive is that it actually burns onto the BDXL or the 100 gigabyte discs no problem. Like, it's not specifically a 4K UHD Blu-ray burner. It is just a Blu-ray burner. And here's the interesting part. It doesn't matter what size the disc is, it'll just burn it. So the standard Blu-ray, like your standard Blu-ray movie, is going to be 25 gigabytes and under, right? And some are going to be double the size. So Blu-ray disc dual layer, like you see right here. I like to use the Verbatim, right? Verbatim brand blanks. They seem to work very well. They don't have too many fails in the burning process, and a lot of the 4K players I have in house play them just fine. The Oppo, the Sony, the Panasonic, and the LG play these just fine. However, you know, there will be times when it won't play it, and maybe times it won't actually burn. This isn't really like a you know, 100% you know, figured out situation. And the biggest and largest blank disk is the BDXL 100 GB. I've actually bought a couple of those, and you know, it's got to be like a special 4K Blu-ray that you really want to put on there, or one that you use all the time, because that blank is going to cost you a pretty penny. So yeah, I'll put links down in the description so you guys can check them out and see what the pricing is. For the most part, I usually use the Blu-ray dual layers for most of my burning. So I try to make sure whatever movie I burn and want to have on a physical disc is under 50 gigabytes. All right, let's move on to software. So I use two different types of software. I use DVD-Fab for the ripping process, and I use Toast Titanium from Roxio for the burning process. Now, I do burn on the Mac. I do not burn on the PC. But if you find a burning software for the PC that will allow you to burn from a disk image, and it will allow you to burn whatever size you want, you know, 25 gigabytes and up, then it should just work. So yeah, you'll have to figure that one out on your own. But I know the Roxio Toast Titanium works without issue. So I use DVD-Fab for ripping the ISO files, and the module that you will need is the UHD copy for 4K Blu-rays and Blu-ray copy for standard Blu-rays. Each of these is $45. All right, so here we are in DVD-Fab. Again, just to remind you guys, we want the copy module. Okay, that's the one we're going to need. UHD copy for this one, or Blu-ray copy for standard Blu-rays. Ripper is the tutorial I showed you guys before, and I actually haven't used any of these other ones, but that's okay. What we want is copy. As you can see, it says full disk over here on the left, and then ISO down here at the bottom, and that's what we're gonna need. So let me pop in the disk. All right, so I popped in the disk. So now DVD-Fab is analyzing the disk. All right, so as you can see, it's got the disk here. Now it says it's 27.5. That's a little bit higher than, that's a BD50. That's what that's gonna be, right? If we were gonna do 25, like, it's gonna try and compress it. So we don't wanna do that. So we wanna keep this 27. So we're gonna select BD50. That means it's gonna be full. Of course, if it says like, you know, 60 or 70 or whatever, then you're gonna wanna go to something higher here on the list so it doesn't compress it. So we get 100% uncompressed, the full disk, and that's pretty much it there. Down here is where we're gonna set our path. So click on this little icon here, and I like to go to 4K ISO rips, and I will save it in this location here, and then I'm gonna click start. All right, so it started analyzing, it started ripping the disk here. So I'm just gonna let it do what it does and pretty much just leave. That's pretty much what I do. So it says an hour 15. This did say like an hour and a half. So I don't even know, you know, obviously it's gonna depend on how many gigabytes the disk is and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, let's just let it do what it does. All right, guys, so here we are. I renamed this because it was some weird name. So just, you know, name it something you can remember. DTS Demo 2017. You can see the size, 27.5 gigabytes is what it was saying in DVD-Fab. And you can see it says disk image file, and the little icon is like this little piece of paper with a disk kind of thing. So, all right, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna transfer this over via my network to my Mac, and that's where I'm gonna do the burn process. Okay, and as for burning, like I said previously, I use Toast Titanium on the Mac, so I'll show you guys how to do that right now. All right, everybody, here we are on the Mac. I have opened up Toast 17 Pro, and basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click copy over here. Now, one of the things you wanna make sure is, like, you can change this to image file, okay? And then we can hit select, and then we can go to the desktop and select our image file, click open, and then it's there, ready to go. So you can do that, or let's see here, let me just quit out of that real quick and get back into Toast Titanium. So what I usually do is I just drag and drop it, and it automatically changes to image file over here. And you can see down here, it's a 27.57. Now, one of the things you want to make sure we do is uncheck this. Use fit to DVD video compression. So that means if the disk here. See on the bottom here, it says BDDL. Let's say if that was BD, then we would have to use this, boom, to fit it. Use fit to DVD video compression. So it'll fit to whatever's on the disk. Down here is your little selector for what kind of blank media you have. So, you know, if we had a BDXL, it would be like space remaining 65 gigabytes, because that's 100 gigabyte blank. BDXL 128, I haven't even seen any of those, so that's pretty cool. BD is too much, right? Space remaining zero. It's a 25 gigabyte disk, so we would need two more gigabytes, so we need to select BDDL. And right here, it's got a destination. It's got the Pioneer already selected, and that's pretty much it. So I just hit copy, and we're good to go. All right, well, that's actually pretty much it. You know, you got your equipment, the ripping device, burning device, got your software, ripping software, burning software, and you got your blanks. And that's kind of it. You know, you extract the ISO file, so it's one large file. You burn that file onto a disk, and you've got your backup for your favorite Blu-ray or your favorite 4K Blu-ray. And then you can put the disk that you purchased, you know, in storage somewhere, so it doesn't get all messed up. If it's one of your kids' favorite movies, then definitely do this so that they, you know, still have that thing, you know, that interactive, you know, aspect of it. They can put the disc in, press close, like all that kind of cool stuff. They can still do that, and you won't have to worry about having to shell out another, you know, $30 for a disc. All right, so speaking about damaged original discs, if you have a disc that's a little bit older and it's got some scratches on it, and noticeably when you're playing the original disc and it has like a glitch, a skip, or something weird happening in there, your backup is also gonna have that. So, you know, I would imagine you probably wanna do this with the newest disc possible, or a disc that really hasn't been handled, you know, a whole lot. So yeah, that's my recommendation there. Like I said previously, this isn't an exact science. Like sometimes one, you know, brand of blank won't work in a certain player, or sometimes that, you know, certain brand of blank won't burn properly. So there's a lot of trial and error in this kind of situation. I've been doing this for years, like started with DVD dual layers, moved on to Blu-rays, Blu-ray dual layers, and just making backups of all of these discs. I used to have one of those 300 disc, you know, DVD carousels that ended up, you know, catching fire. And good thing I did it, because, you know, no, not good thing the fire happened, but good thing I backed them up, because all my original discs were still safe somewhere else. They were actually in a storage unit down in LA, and this fire happened here in Mammoth. So I had like all the movies still on disc somewhere else. So that was really cool, and that definitely was helpful in, you know, rebuilding when I got my hands back on those discs. But anyway, that's pretty much it. If you guys have questions about this, let me know down in the comments. And again, if you need a 4K friendly drive for your computer, make sure you hit up Alex and tell him TechnoDad sent you. All right, so happy burning. Let me know what happens. Let me know if you get stuck somewhere. And of course, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And see you guys next time. Peace.